In today's video, I'm going to show how to train a model for predicting house prices in a Python application using TensorFlow and Keras. Prepare the files that we need in order to be able to use the same model in a JavaScript app using TensorFlow.js and convert the model. The final result of this two parts video is a Vue.js app which expects the size of the apartment, number of bedrooms, bathrooms, parking spaces, the neighborhood so that it can return the price for the house. For the complete application, we'll have two projects, one written in Python for training the model using Keras and TensorFlow as the backend, and another one written using JavaScript for the web app using Vue.js and TensorFlow.js. So let's start. Inside the Python project, we have several Python files, one for training the model, one for predicting, another one for converting some data for later use inside the JavaScript app, and finally, a set of commands underscore somethings with stuff to be reused inside the other Python files. Also, we have a folder for the dataset which only has a CSV file with a row per house price. In each row, we have the price, the size in meters, number of rooms, baths, parking spaces, and finally the neighborhood in which the house is located. The dataset was cleaned a little bit, but it could use some more cleaning. A folder for storing the different trained models using different parameters, like if the model was trained using feature scaling or categorical encoding. And finally, one with all the files needed on the web app for making predictions, like the converted model, mean and variance for the scaled features, and the list of neighborhoods. Let's start with the common.py modules, in which we define first the default folder for storing the files related to the model, and then also create a folder if it doesn't exist already. The file name for the final version of the model and also for the checkpoints. And the column names that we are using for the input and output of the model. On the common-visualization.py, I have a function for plotting the different metrics for the model so that it is easier to analyze its performance later. The common-scaler.py with the functions needed for creating and loading the scaler and one for normalizing the current data. The common-categorical.py with similar functions for also creating and loading an encoder and one for encoding a categorical feature. Inside the common-pre-post-processing.py, a function for preprocessing input columns and another one for post-processing output values using the scaler and the categorical encoders. And finally, inside the common-file.py, a function for creating JSON files, mostly for sharing stuff with the TensorFlow.js app. Inside the trainModel.py, we define different cells as with the previous video. In the first one, I import several libraries that we need for training the model, like pandas for importing and working with the dataset, scikit-learn for splitting the dataset, TensorFlow for checking the version and what type of device we're using given that we're using it as the backend for Keras, several Keras modules for creating and training the model, and our common-somethings modules. In the next cell, I load the dataset in CSV format. Divide the data frame into the inputs and outputs that we need for the model and print the first few items. In the next cells, I create the categorical encoder for the neighborhood and a scalar for the numeric features. I will explain more about scaling and one hot encoding in future videos. Then I use scikit-learn for splitting the dataset into a train and test sets, and then print the size and a few items for each one. I transform the inputs and outputs into the format that the network understands using the One Hot Encoder and the scaler for the training and validation datasets. I then define a simple model with only one dense layer with 100 units, ReLU as the activation and dropout. And then another dense layer with the size of the outputs, which in this case will be the price for the house. The model is compiled using Adam for the optimizer, mean squared error as the loss function, and mean absolute error for the metrics. Finally, we print the summary describing the model that we built. Then I define some hyperparameters for the model, like how many epochs to iterate and the batch size, and some callbacks for Keras for creating checkpoints for the model, and also one for stopping the training if we haven't improved for 20 epochs. In the next cell, I train the model and start the history for later analysis. Then I save the model to a file so it can be used later, and then evaluate and print the results. Finally, I plot the results of the training session so that we can visualize better the performance of the model. And finally, for the predict.py file, we import the load model module from Keras and also our common modules. I load the trained model using the file name that we defined before. I define a little sample of data to predict using the size in meters, number of rooms, baths, parking spaces, and the neighborhood in which a property is located. I transform the inputs into the format and ranges expected by the network, call the predict function, and transform the outputs into a more understandable format, and finally print the results. This is a similar process that we are going to follow for the web app. First, we will load the model, load the encoders and scalers, and once we input some values, we need to transform them into the form that the network understands. Call predict, post-process the outputs, and then print them. Inside the share preprocessing tfjs py file, I included the common modules as I have been doing for the other files. I load the categorical encoder, get the list of classes, and then store them in a JSON file. Then I load the scaler, given that I am using the standard scaler, I get the mean and variance for the inputs and outputs, and finally also save them in JSON format. Before we start working on the Vue.js app, let's first prepare the model so that it can be used inside TensorFlow.js by using the TensorFlow.js converter. You can install the converter by using pip install TensorFlow.js or Docker. The image is included in the project. Then inside the folder in which you have your Python project, just call the converter, specifying that it is a Keras model, the relative path into the H5 model file, and the folder in which the converted model should be placed. After that, you should see that there are a couple of files for your model on that folder. In the next couple of videos, we will be discussing a little more about scaling features, One Hot Encoding, and finally, we will create a TensorFlow.js application using JavaScript. We will take the converted model, the values for normalizing, and the neighborhood list so that we can use it for predicting house prices. Awesome! Congratulations and thanks for watching! And if you like the video, please hit subscribe.